The district season is underway, and three of our Mesquite ISD football teams are off to a good start. Welcome to the pregame show. I'm Ted Madden. The big game of the week featured North against Horn. Darius White was back at quarterback for the Jags, even though that's not his natural position. But you can see his natural athleticism as he escaped pressure and launched a touchdown pass to Derek Jackson. That's a 35-yard scoring play, and Horn led 7-0. North came back on an even longer touchdown pass. Sophomore Luke Cedar let fly to Elijah Baeza, who ran away with a 69-yard score. It was 7-6 after North failed on the two-point try. White carried the offense for the Jags, 161 passing yards, plus another 157 on the ground and this touchdown. Horn gets its first win of the season, 25-6 over North.
You know, when district starts, everybody's on an even playing field. Everybody's 0-0 when district starts. So really focusing on, we got to start district the right way. We did, and we talked to the kids about it. You know, hey, we're 1-0 in district. There's three teams in district that are 1-0.
The Jaguars will play a Rockwall Heath team coming off a 79-71 double overtime win over rival Rockwall. In Horn's win over North, Chris Dawn had 5 catches for 93 yards. The Stallions have their bye week, so they won't play again until October 8th at Rockwall Heath. The Skeeters played their first district game against Skyline, and the defense stepped up again. The unit allowed only 117 total yards, and one of the highlights was this interception by Jalen Broadus. Skyline had a 6-0 lead late in the second quarter until Chance Edwards hooked up with Jamarion Woods for a 17-yard touchdown, and the Skeeters led 7-6 at halftime. Edwards and Woods combined for another touchdown in the third quarter, and don't look now, but Mesquite has won 3 in a row. They beat Skyline 16-6.
We get in that circle after practice every week, and then we just look around and say, these are the guys that matter. And so our attitude, our effort, and just the core values and all those things that we're preaching, let's just focus on those and the wins will come.
The Skeeters have a big test this week with a game against Rockwall, and Coach Harris says he wouldn't have it any other way. Anthony Roberts had another productive game on the ground with 20 carries for 98 yards. Poteet will play its toughest district opponent, South Oak Cliff, at Memorial Stadium Friday night. The Pirates are 3-0 in district play after beating Hillcrest 35-28. Running back Joey Shaw ran for 169 yards and a touchdown. West Mesquite was up for the challenge against Longview last Thursday at Memorial. Longview was ahead 14-0 but had trouble with this exchange, and Willie Williams scooped up the loose ball and returned it 70 yards for a score. That made it 14-6 Lobos. West Mesquite quarterback Craig Dale threw 3 touchdown passes, 2 of them in the first half, and this game was tied at 21 at halftime. But Longview pulled away to win 56-28. The Wranglers will play at beautiful McKinney ISD Stadium this week against the McKinney North Bulldogs. In the Longview loss, TJ Turner had 5 catches for 89 yards and 2 scores. Jesus Nino had the other offensive touchdown on a 4-yard catch. Horn's cross-country team finished ahead of both Tyler Legacy and Rockwall Heath at a recent meet, something the program had never done. This team is led by seniors Omari Sandifer and Alejandro Villalva, who set a school record last year and has broken it twice this year.
So he's coming third at this Frisco meet, this last meet, and I think he sees himself getting to state this year. He'll do whatever he needs to do. Yep, he's changed his diet, like his warm-up is longer. It's like he is laser-focused on being the absolute best that he can be.
That's all the time we have this week for the pregame show. Thank you for supporting Mesquite ISD Athletics, and enjoy your game.